Today I'll show you how to export the results of a CAM simulation to an STL file and then load that STL file as a new body and use that new body as the stock material for a second setup. This part has two setups. The first setup is for operations on the back side of the part, while the second setup is operations on the front side of the part. Rotating the part to the back side, we can see that the stock material is set to a relative box size slightly larger than the actual part. We'll first perform the simulation on the back side to produce the stock material for the front side. We can jump to the end of all of the tool paths by selecting this icon. To save the STL file of the simulation, first right click on the background and go to stock, save stock. We'll call this stock 2 and press save. Close out of the simulation and switch to the modeling environment. In the modeling environment, select insert, insert mesh, and select this STL file. Leave the units as the same as the units of the model. And this imports a mesh body. We won't be able to use this for stock yet. We first have to convert this to a BREP. Select new body at operation and press OK. And we can now delete the mesh body. We'll change the name of the newly created BREP to stock 2 and turn it off. Now switch back to the CAM environment. And just for comparison, we'll look at the stock for setup 2, which was originally a relative size box. But this doesn't show the contour operations that have already taken place, nor does it include the drilling operations that were performed in the first setup. So we'll edit setup 2, select stock, change from relative size box to from solid. Now we have to select the solid that is our stock. Expand out the list of bodies and select stock 2 and press OK. We can already see that the contour from the first setup has been performed and the drill and operations have been formed as well. We can select simulation and press play. And let's turn off transparency on the stock. We can see that hole that was performed in the first setup. Let's speed up our simulation just a little bit. We see a glimpse of another hole, and now it's fully exposed. Switch the transparency back on. By taking the simulation results from a previous setup and saving that as an STL file, loading that back in and producing a stock body for the next setup, you're able to improve the collision detection and machining operations